Alright guys, we got another battle report going. This is my little lineup right here. So we've got a Goblin Wolf Chariot, Giant Orcs. There's 29 Orcs. My BSB's in the unit. And all he's got is shield, plate armor, and the talisman of supreme shielding. I got another 10 Orcs right here with my level 4 Shaman. And he's got the Path of Wilderness, Gem of Dragonfire, and the Book of 1,000 Incantations. I've got my 20 Night Goblins with my level 1, who is a Path of Shadows. He's got the Dispel Scroll and the Talisman of Lesser Shielding with Power Mushrooms. I think I already said Power Mushrooms, didn't I? Either way. Over here, we got a Scrap Wagon with plus 1 Strength and the Steady, whatever it is, pursuit mode, which gives him he makes his pursuit steady, so instead of going random direction. 30 feral orcs with spears and shields, and my general, who has plate armor, shield, sprout of rebirth, dragon scale helm, and the axe of battle with a speed potion. So that's gonna be fun. Got another scrap wagon, it's the exact same as this one. Another Goblin Wolf Chariot, 28 Gnasher Herd. Now, I didn't realize this when I put them all together, but apparently they don't have the cave goblins in the back anymore supporting the three Gnashers, so let's just pretend these guys are Gnashers. I've got the Gargantula and another Goblin Wolf Chariot. And now for Tuna Sandwichifies army.
Stuffing my face with peach right now.
It is glorious.
Alright, so this is my Warp Stream Cannon, 7 Wrath Knights with full command War Banner and War Plus Weapons, 2 Lust Chariot, or no, sorry, these are 2 Change Chariots, 5 Dogs, 2 Lust Chariots. My General, this is going to be an interesting run, he's got a 1 up, 4 up, and then he's got the Blessed of the Gods mark, which I gave him plus 1 toughness, so he's got 6 strength, 6 toughness, with the, 6 strength with the plus 1 strength sword, and 6 toughness. Then I have my favored, I have 25 favored, full command, with the Razor Banner, the Razor Standard. The champion has the Screaming swords, so that he causes fear, and he's got the additional attack. And I have my BSB, who has the Hardened Shield. I gave him Sword of Bashing, plus 1 to hit, and then Sorcerer's Bane, which deals magic res 1 and makes his unit immune to augment and hex spells that don't cause damage. And then he also has the Blessed by the Gods, and I'm going to give him plus 1 wound, so he's got 3 wounds. And then I have my level, he's actually a level 3 shadow, he has the Lucky Shield, Dispel Scroll. I think that's all I gave to him.
And also, if you see these, he's got a little wound markers.
Oh, and a Talisman of Lesser Shielding, so he's 6 up. Yeah, I got my little...
Seems pretty cool, they got little skulls on them for the amount of...
Miniature market. Nice little things. Just a dowel rod on a freaking space. And then another unit of dogs. He deployed most of his army first, so I think I had 5 units left, so you pretty much auto fucking...
Yeah, unless I roll a 1, and with my...
Even if you win a roll a 1, and I roll a 6, you got plus 5.
We tie.
So we tie. So no matter, it's going to be an internal roll if I keep getting 6s somehow.
Yeah.
So you win the first roll.
Yeah, so I guess I got first turn, even though my rolling really sucks. So we're not going to chance it.
Oh, yeah, we got to do... somehow you roll a 0.
Yeah.
We do magic too.
Yep. And since I got Pathmaster and I'm taking the signature spell for him, I don't really have to roll for my spells. Score. But we'll return after Orcs and Goblins turn 1. Alright, so Orcs and Goblins turn one looks like this and moved up everybody. Nothing really too big. I forgot to do the power mushrooms on him, so I did those now and he only got three. So magic phase was interesting. I got a plus one strength and toughness on them. I did.
You cast what's it called?
Yeah, I cast shed on my asthma. It was
the other one, the wild.
Curse of the Wildwood. I cast Curse of the Wildwood on them.
Yeah.
But I.
And he forgot that.
Instantly forgot
when I told you what he had on him.
Yeah. Instantly forgot.
To hex and augment spells. You tried to push the augment
that don't cause damage. That don't cause damage.
Yeah, they don't.
And this one
damage.
Doesn't cause damage immediately, but it causes damage when they move. So, if anybody has any words for that, just let us know if we play it wrong or not. And then I got Shadow Miasma off on his general, and he got minus two to his
weapon skill,
ballistic movement. Skill, movement, and initiative.
Yeah.
And I rolled three sixes, and he took my level one took no wounds, and I lost two regular cave goblins. So, lucky. Rolled a one. Thank you, ones. And now it's on to Chaos... Or no, Warriors of the Dark Gods is their name.
Let's see.
Yeah. Yeah. It's their turn one now.
Yep.
Alright.
Deployment looks third. Deployment. Movement looks like this. Not really much of it.
A lot of moving backwards.
Back a little bit because he has no shooting, and I do. For once. I'm gonna move my dogs up. Magic, I
gasp.
Negative one movement on him, and that was it. And then, as you can see here, his little gobos are six left, and his mage is dead because a direct hit cannon shot hit every single one of them. And without lookout, sir.
And strength.
The fact that.
Lookout, sir, doesn't exist anymore. Just everything goes into the unit.
Yeah,
I think.
Unless there's no place for the hit to go into the unit. So.
Correct us if we're wrong.
Yeah, if we're wrong, correct us, but that's my assumption is...
Because I would assume...
Every single model was under the template, including the caster, so...
Wait, I think everything does go into the actual unit. It's only if you obliterate the entire unit, then it would hit.
That doesn't make much sense. Well, we'll look it up, and y'all at home, fucking let us know in the comments. We may figure it out prior to, but... Comment, just all the same. Other than that, it is off to Orcs and Goblins' turn. Dose.
Yup. All right, so Orcs and Goblins' turn two. So what happened is moved up just a teensy bit with all these guys right here. He moved 11 inches from here. Everybody else moved up. He had dogs there, but they're gone now because my scrap wagon right here killed him down to one guy left. He failed his four up rerollable.
Because
the general and BSB were in range. And he failed it. He ran. He got double sixes, I think it was. But
he got double sixes.
Yeah.
Right,
so you got
run down easy.
Yeah, I rolled a 3d6 to chase him down and surprise him for a second because he forgot that I go 3d6 when I'm pursuing, and I went 15 inches.
This is the first time you've used pump wagons.
Hey, whatever. So I got 15 inches on the pursuit, and I ran straight into the warriors.
Which I'm fine with.
And then this one right here, I almost lost.
One.
I got a one on the roll. It's a d6 plus one because I got scythes. And
the only deaths he did.
The only kills that he was two dead. And I got one wound, but I won by two. He lost by a three up roll.
I rolled double sixes to get away.
So that happened over there. And then magic. So this is what happened. We decided, look at the rules, and it says that characters, if there is more than five models in the unit, any
template, it everything goes rank and file if there's five or more models of the same type as the character.
So
even though the template hit everybody or touched every model, it still goes all into the character, into the unit rather than the character.
Yep.
I'm assuming it's because unless it wipes out the every single one of them, then the rank and file, then it's like one of the goblins jumps in front or something.
So this magic phase, I got frenzy on them, and I did curse of the wildwood on these knights over here. And
horribly.
Yep. And it does any move.
It doesn't matter because you didn't get it off.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, that's right. I didn't get it off.
Yeah,
that's
I don't know why you didn't explain that.
I forgot. I have a really terrible memory.
You're worse than me.
So yeah, now it's on to
Warrior's
turn. Deuce.
Alright, so movement. Didn't really go anywhere. Again, because I have shooting, he has to come to me. So here, I just moved these guys. My two chains chariots moved, shifted to the left. He charged into the now non-existent pump wagon.
Scrap wagon.
Scrap wagon, sorry. And then...
GW's gonna sue.
I didn't actually... I think I... Did I kill it automatically? Yeah. I killed...
Well,
I ended up killing... I didn't kill it automatically.
You killed him with your horses, finally.
The horses fucking punched him in the face. Killed him, and then I chose to overrun and went into his chariot here. His pump wagon did...
Three?
No, you did 9 impact hits.
9 impact hits, 3 wounds.
Actually wounded. One, I saved... Or 4 wounded, I saved 1. 3 of these guys died, and then I made with my BSB, and, you know, I don't give it any...
5 attacks, yeah, 5 hits.
5 attacks, 5 wounds, all dead. And my dogs ran off the board over here.
Yeah!
So, oh, and again, template, direct hit on these fuckers. I tried doing the negative toughness buff
on these guys.
Those guys, and you dispelled it by 1. Damn it. And then
you
did
shadow miasma.
Yeah, I did miasma, -1 movement on them.
Yep.
And frenzies, I thought their frenzy was not remaining in play, so it's off now.
That's right. Okay.
You didn't get them at this your last magic phase.
Yeah, so I'm, So frenzy's gone. So
yeah. It is now Orcs and Goblins turn 3.
It is. Okay, so turn 3 for Orcs and Goblins look like this.
Shitty for him.
Really shitty. So failed frenzy for them. And they had to charge into the chariot that was here. I charged into the chariot just because they're strength 5.
He did that prior to remembering.
Prior to
frenzy
that right there. I moved my little shaman out of
the one
unit.
Fucking
and moved him up here just because I have
somehow,
2 fanatics still.
Somehow there's 2 fanatics hidden behind the banner over there.
He's got him under his robe.
Yeah.
And then this right here. So I made 2 pretty much max distance charges. And I got him with both of them.
This was kind of a bullshit fucking combat for
Complete bullshit for me. So I do 2 wounds with my Gargantula, 1 wound with him, and then 1 wound with these guys.
Oh, I failed my fear test because of the terror.
Yeah, and we figured that out after we did all this. So it
after I did all my attacks.
Yeah, after I did all of his attacks. So it may have made a difference, maybe not. Doesn't matter. It is a friendly game, not a tournament, so it doesn't matter. This one, miraculously, I got a wound off of this one,
mm-hmm.
and killed one guy.
He killed
the entire back rank.
My guys,
and they were all like 3 up armor saves for most of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then just because he has a fucking musician
and the combat
res banner,
he had one his charge.
Wait, do you have 2 banners in your game?
No, it's
2 magical banners.
It's the regular banner. The standard bearer gives you +1, and then the war banner gives you +1 combat reps.
War banner? Is that a veteran standard?
Yeah. No, it's just a magic standard.
That's considered veteran standard, right?
Yes.
You only get 1 per
they're
army.
Allowed to have... No. That's for core units. Knights can have... Knights are fucking special.
Oh, it's only for core... Okay. So, yeah, so... Bullshit musician made me lose. It didn't do anything to my leadership, but they both failed their leadership test. Because goblins, 6 leadership. Luckily, he only ran 4. Ran 7 here and 11 there. Obviously. Oh, so I made him turn around. He turned. Just in case. I guess we're turning forward. Didn't really get anything else off.
Yeah, he couldn't reform over here.
Yeah, because my...
these guys had to...
Feral Orcs had to overrun. They ran, bumped into
And bumped into him, and then his... He could have reformed them to be different, like, a different formation, but he decided to just leave them like that. So...
Yeah.
I think it was probably because he didn't think this would happen.
Yeah, I figured they would all die. Because...
Now, it's the only issue is the possibility of a flank charge there.
Which would suck balls.
Because they have to flee, and I'm definitely going to fucking charge at them.
Yep.
So, it is off to Warriors turn 3.
Yes, right. It is.
Alright.
Alright,
so my shit looked like this. I charged the knights into the gargantuan, and he fled, and then he only went,
I only went like four or five inches on that new.
I needed a 12 to get him, I got a 13, and didn't fail any of my danger strain. These guys made their charges into here, did like killed eight on impact hits, lost one wound each, and was able to win combat, but he was steadfast and stuck. Then over here, when I did these charges, by the way, I ensured that the little shit with his two freaking
fanatics
in there was out of 8 inches of where I was going. So this guy, when he charged, is the front of them, did it so he angled straight like this and was out of the 8-inch movement or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And then magic, I think everything I attempted was dispelled, right?
Yeah.
And I had ended with like 2 extra dice, but didn't matter. And then my hell cannon, who has been on point,
direct hit after direct hit,
every single time.
I even checked.
Direct hit on his one dice. Goblin and killed him with a 2.
Yeah.
He didn't need anything but, and just got a 2 barely.
Yeah.
But we had to check the freaking dice.
Make sure it wasn't loaded.
But yeah.
I rolled a direct hit once with his die, and then I rolled it again, and it was a directional one. I think it caught my fingerprints.
That was definitely scary. But anyway, I moved these guys up a little bit, moved him over here to keep that guy in check.
Yep.
And yeah, so off to Orcs.
Turn four. Yep.
All right, so this was your turn, so you want to go over it?
Yeah, so I did a little reform for these guys to get more into combat and give me some more ranks. It worked. Helped me out. Right here, did a swift reform. Moved these guys back. Made the charges with my chariot.
Oh, yeah.
Goblin Wolf chariot went over here. He Wolf got in on the flank. He died.
One impact hit
that killed. Charged in my orcs that I needed a... I called the WOG. Oh, you know what? I didn't add the extra attacks for the WOG.
You get extra attacks for the WOG?
Devastating charge. Gets +1 to attack.
I will roll those fucking attacks.
Yeah, so I'll need to do +1 more attack for the 9 that I did.
Do you get plus one attack for... Or is it just the front rank?
I think it's just the front rank. We'll have to check.
We'll figure that out.
We'll check back. We'll come back in a second after that. My giant did jump. I killed 4.
Yeah,
4 guys, and
you had 5. I killed. I got 8.
You 8, but I was steadfast
because
I had
1 rank.
5 ranks, and you only
one
had
more
4.
Rank than I did.
I did 1 wound each over here. So now
magic really didn't do anything. You got frenzy off of these guys, and then
yep.
I think I dispelled everything.
Yeah, I was trying to do the +1 toughness, +1 strength
for
them.
Yeah, I let frenzy through and then dispelled toughness with all my dice.
Yeah.
So, check on that devastating charge, WOG thing, and then go into warrior's turn 4.
Yep. Okay, so you go ahead and explain your turn.
All right, so what happened was these knights charged from in the woods, took out his chariot, lost 1 to dangerous terrain.
Overran
because he had rallied these guys. Then I think we did the combat here
Yep.
The impact
hits and some other stuff.
Not the impact hits, but for your devastating charge.
Yes.
You only did one, or you did
three extra.
You did two wounds, which tied the combat.
Yeah, to it, yeah,
so
that's
he
right.
Didn't, he Sorry. Didn't lose the combat this time, or initially. So then after that, on my turn, I had my general charge in to his giant. Then for magic, I got the negative one toughness off on the giant and mind razor on my chosen, or my favored.
Mm-hmm.
And the question actually came up because the giant was right here, the rest of the orcs were here, and then my favored were here. My general was exactly right here. He went in, did all but one wound to the giant.
And then your favored guy.
So then we went to the favored's turn, and the one favored who was able to get his supporting tax into the giant killed the giant. Now, the question I have is, is he out of combat now? And if so, can he, because he is out of combat, do a combat reform? Otherwise, he's just stuck here with some freaking savages coming up his butthole.
Feral orcs.
His feral orcs, whatever. Anyways, the combat here, because of the auto wound with freaking mind razor, which is disgusting.
Hella disgusting.
I just wrecked his freaking orcs and
yeah.
Overran. Or they broke. They auto broke. I overran, killed them.
Landed in my 10 guys right here.
And this guy, this motherfucker, got his one little fucking orc.
Still loaded dice.
Who was sitting right there by his lonesome, and popped him with a direct hit again.
Mm-hmm.
Killed him. So this, I think, is going to be the last turn.
Yeah.
Turn six for the orcs and.
Or turn five.
Oh, did you already rotate it?
Yeah, I just rotated it down, so it's turn five.
Turn five.
This will be the end of the game because it's getting pretty late. It's
late,
like 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
And we got wives.
Yeah.
They're going to be mad at us.
So, off to orcs turn five.
I'm ready.
Ready. Right, so, your turn.
Yep, as would have it, I charge as general, and he flees. Like a bitch!
But they're not cornered anymore, so
yeah.
They can flee if they want to.
Well,
and he's expensive as shit. He's but like 425 points yeah. Plus 100 for the general.
He's more expensive than my unit right here.
Yeah.
But anyways, so he comes up and he charges in. These guys, they overran my orcs into my
into your orc bunker.
Yep.
And then they, because of Mind Razor, I auto-wound on everything.
So imagine if I had Mind Razor on a horde of savage, or a horde of feral orcs.
Somebody other than a freaking level 1 shadow then.
He
got his strength, plus 1 strength and toughness buff off on that unit, which didn't matter because...
He was auto-wounding.
Mind Razor auto-wounding. So I annihilated all the way down to 2 guys, and they fled, and I had to pursue because they were... Actually, crap, I didn't have to pursue with Wrath. Not that it matters, because that could have been a good fight. Because I rallied him on my turn. I charged his last two guys and caught him. I rolled double sixes and you rolled freaking like a 4.
Yeah.
Or something. We essentially just called it after that. But
these guys didn't get to see any action.
They got... See, what happened was...
Killed one chariot in a failed frenzy.
Yeah.
Assholes.
Your frenzy just fucked you up.
But they look pretty.
They did look very pretty.
They look so good.
I mean, how many points is that unit?
This is, like a 300...
Just subtract that from what you had, from 2,500.
This is a 355. 355? 355 point, block with a 280 point general. So this is like a 500 plus point block right here.
So
you get about 2,000 points out of me. Plus, yeah. And then you take into account the 1, 2, 3, 4 banners that I had. No, you have the orcs, the night goblins, the cave goblins.
I didn't get the night goblins because I didn't win it in combat. Unless they changed that rule. I blew them the fuck up.
Yeah. Well, you're freaking awesome hits.
Auto hits with my fucking hell cannon. His, my warp screen cannon.
It's loaded. It's a loaded die.
Loaded dice. Hold on.
Where is he? Steve, roll it again. Fucking loaded.
One more time?
Do it again.
Are you fucking
loaded dice. Do you see it? Do you see it? It's cheater.
See?
Alright.
Third one.
Yeah, third one.
Again?
Yeah. It's a direct hit. Wow. Look at this. He's got it loaded. It's like some sort of Arduino freaking motherboard in there.
Either way.
Either tweaks way. The weight every now and again.
Yeah, so.
And people are getting fishy about it.
Yeah, I think we'll do the math and then just at the end of our video we'll throw it in there.
I'll put it in the description because I don't. Yeah. I just throw these things together and.
I was
hope
rolling
good.
Horrible in the beginning. You were rolling your magic.
Oh my god!
Amazing.
Whoa.
Mine but sucked balls.
I didn't have so my magic was great, but with that magic, I didn't have anybody in combat, and my spells are really just some pretty good buffs. But I think I probably should have taken something else, like maybe.
I think your shirt comes into play here.
I know it really does. It's all fun and games. Somebody fails an armor saving throw.
Every single time.
Yeah, and then my other shirt says well shit, and it's got a one on a d20.
Mm-hmm.
Because.
Yeah, I mean, I think
one in 20 chances.
Like I said, my arm is straight up chariots and a big rock. I think if you had your actual like normal war machines, you probably would have done something more.
I would have crushed all your chariots.
Yeah, because you probably would have been rolling hits like I was.
Yeah, that's... Like I said before, this is my first time doing a list without any shooting whatsoever. Minus the night goblin, or the cave goblins with the short bows. And I didn't do any shooting with my gargantula. So, I really had absolutely no shooting. And now if I decided to do a 3,000 point list with this, I'd have two git launchers, two splatterers, two gargantulas, and I'd still go under the 25% rare.
See, my thing is if you...
And I'd still be able to take everything exactly the same.
If you were to have...
Your phone die?
Yeah, my phone ran out of space, I think.
Anyway. I always take off my videos as it makes them, just remove everything. But continue, I'll put it in mine.
Anyways. What if my phone died, so we'll see the rest of this rant on his. If you were to put or had your artillery, I would have been shooting him into your artillery instead of your goblins.
Yeah, it's like the only target
the only target I had, and that's the only thing that died to my shooting. That
but you were hitting direct hits all the time, so it didn't really matter what you were shooting at.
It was definitely like extremely lucky. Normally I don't take warp screen cannons, but since Ninth came out, I've been trying them out and doing a few more games than just one, and then getting pissed off and getting it out of my list.
Just throwing it out.
But,
I think I'm gonna try this next one. The next game that we play, you know, probably not gonna be next weekend because I'm gonna be out of town.
I'm gonna be in Missouri, so
yeah, we're all gonna be out of town, so we're not gonna have a game next weekend. But I think next list I make, I'm probably going to take my Orc Warlord
at least have on a Wyvern.
I want to have two Doom Divers in this next list and one Splatterer. Or I'll have... Yeah. I think one Git Launcher and two Splatterers. Because the Splatterers are cheaper. The Git Launcher, for the points, even though it's really accurate, for the points of just doing 1d6... And not being able to get anything else, or any, it's just kind of.
I mean, against my chariots, it would.
It's nice, good. But with the kind of rolls I get,
do well.
The kind of rolls I get, I pick and choose.
Yeah. Anyways, it's time for sleep.
Yep. Until next time.
Thanks for watching.
I'll see you guys later.
Later.